Hey everyone, I'm Manuela with Plytix, and today we're gonna talk about product families. When you're dealing with a wide range of products, you'll have attributes or data points that are only relevant to a specific group of products. Let's say you sell toys. Your battery-powered toys will need attributes like battery type or voltage, while your traditional toys won't. Having these attributes appear in unrelated products can create a mess and might even cause you to overlook an attribute that is important to that product. This is where product families come in. By using product families, you can assign attributes to products of the same type so that you only see the relevant attributes for each family. For example, if your business sells sports equipment, then you might want to create a product family for tennis rackets and a different one for golf clubs. This way, when you want to enrich product information for your tennis rackets, you'll see attributes that are relevant, like string pattern and grip size, but those same attributes won't show up when you're trying to enrich the product information for golf clubs. On the other hand, you'll still see attributes that apply to both, like brand name or model. Assigning products to the right family saves you time by making it easier to locate, edit, and share the information that you need. Implementing families in Plytix is easy. Under the Settings tab here, you'll see a menu for products. Under this, select Families, and then click on Create a Family. After naming your family, you'll choose all of the individual attributes or even entire attribute groups that are relevant for the products in that family. And when you're done, click Create Family. Now you'll need to assign products to the family that you've just created. And the best way to do that is to sort your products using filters. So let's head over to the product overview page where you can do that. Here, you can filter by an attribute that is specific to the products that you want to add to your new family. In this example, we'll filter by apparel size is defined in order to create an apparel family. This will exclude our other products like phone cases and tote bags since they don't have this attribute defined. Now you can select all of the products that have been filtered and assign them to your new family. When you view products in this family, you'll no longer see attributes of other products like phone model, since this isn't an apparel-related attribute. For users who are familiar with Plytix, you might be wondering, okay, but what about attribute groups? Well, attribute groups are still super useful, but you may want to use them a little bit differently if you currently use them to organize your products by type. The best way to use attribute groups and product families together is to use attribute groups for grouping similar attributes and product families for grouping similar products. Let's go back to our sports equipment example. You'd create a product family for each different equipment type. So like we mentioned before, you'd have a product family for tennis rackets and a different product family for golf clubs. And if you sell sports apparel, you can create one family for all of the apparel or even niche down and make a family for each type of apparel. So you might want to create a family for t-shirts and a separate one for pants. When it comes to attribute groups, you can create groups to organize all of your attributes. So you can group all of the basic information together, the dimension attributes together. You can have an attribute group for all of your media, and that would include the attributes like thumbnail, image gallery, product video. You can also create attributes to organize data by language-specific content or individual channel requirements, which can help you focus on a set of attributes when you're enriching your product data. Now, how product families and attribute groups come together is that not all of these attributes will apply to every product. So by assigning products to families, you'll only see the attributes from each group that are relevant to that family. So where for a tennis racket, you might see a dimension attribute like grip size and weight. For a t-shirt, you might only see length and width attributes from that group. But if you look at either of these items, you'll see the basic information that they both share, like availability, price, and description. So try it out and let me know in the comments below how product families and attribute groups are working for you. For more best practices and tips on using product families, be sure to check out the Plytix community, which I'll link below in the description. And you can also find in-depth explanations of how to implement families in your Plytix account in our Help Center, which I'll also link below. I hope you find this video tutorial helpful, and if you have any questions whatsoever, don't hesitate to reach out to us by using our chat on our website.